Hello everyone, I'm Sarfraz from MobileSMSPK.net and today I'm going to review Qmobile Noir S6. So let's get started. I have already made unboxing video of Qmobile Noir S6 and recommending you to watch that video as well. Let's start with call quality of the phone. Call quality is very good, voices are crisp and clear on both ends. I have not faced any problem at all during my test. Let me give you physical overview of the phone. On front there is 5 megapixel camera along with LED notification, 5 inch HD IPS display and fingerprint scanner, micro USB port and 3.5mm headphone jack on the top, volume rockers and power button on the right, microphone and speaker grill on the bottom, nothing on the left, 13 megapixel camera along with LED flash on the back of the phone, Noir branding and Qmobile branding. Phone might come in different colors, but right now only gold color is available in market. Build quality of Qmobile Noir S6 is solid, but it is made of plastic. That's why it is not feel very premium, but definitely not cheap either. Let me show you how fast fingerprint sensor is. Button is clickable, but to unlock the device, you only need to tap on that. If phone remains on standby mode for longer period of time, then you need to press power button first to wake up the phone and then fingerprint sensor to unlock the device. Fingerprint sensor is fast, but sometimes it is not responding altogether for a couple of minutes. You can use home button in 3 different ways. Either you can tap on it, click on it, or long press it. There are a couple of options if you press home button for long. Either switch off the device or show Google search. It acts like back button if you just tap on it. If you click the button, then it acts like home button and take you to the home screen. Let me show you how to add fingerprint sensor. Qmobile Noir S6 has 16GB of internal storage, from which around 11GB is available out of the box. You can always expand internal storage through microSD card slot. Phone supports up to 64GB card. Phone comes with 2GB of RAM, from which 1.2GB is available on first boot. Qmobile Noir S6 has 3G capabilities and 2 dedicated SIM card slots, so you can use 2 SIMs and microSD cards simultaneously. Sound is loud and clear. It is always good to have speakers at the bottom of the phone rather than on the back. So if your phone lying on the desk, your speaker won't get muffled, though it might get blocked while watching videos or playing games. Let me show you the quality of the speakers. Qmobile Noir S6 has 5-inch HD IPS display with resolution of 720p. Display looks bright and sharp. Even though it is not full HD display, but you won't notice any pixel on the phones. Color saturation is good, however color tone is little bit on cooler side. There are 4 additional themes available on the phone and this is how they look. Viewing angles are good. You might notice some color shift on extreme angles, but text remains visible. Sunlight visibility is acceptable. You can use this phone outside without any problem. Though it is not up to the mark of higher-end phones, but it is usable. Qmobile Nord S6 is powered by 1.3 GHz quad-core processor with MediaTek MT6580 chipset. Phone also has 2GB of RAM and Mali 400MP GPU. Phone has accelerometer, proximity and light sensors. Here is AnTuTu score. And here is Geekbench single and double core score. Day-to-day performance is good, but you might notice some lags. This issue is quite common with entry-level smartphones which come with 2GB of RAM. And because Qmobile Nord S6 is entry-level phone, so you cannot compare it with high-end mobile phones. Neither you can expect it to outperform Galaxy or iPhone. Phone supports up to 5 finger touch. Phone does not support OTG. Qmobile Nord S6 runs on Android Marshmallow 6.0. UI is very light and close to stock Android. That's why phones performs very well in day-to-day tasks. There are a couple of additional features added by Qmobile in settings, like you can swipe on-screen navigational buttons. Gestures like double tap to wake or flip to mute are missing, but there are sliding gestures provided by Qmobile from which you can use double finger gestures on home screen. Sliding down opens phone book while sliding up launches messaging app. Qmobile phones usually comes with numbers of blockwares. This phone is not exception. There is GameLoft folder in which there are 4 games which cannot be deleted without rooting your device, and because these are only trial versions, so you cannot play them either. but you have option to disable them. Some useful apps are also pre-installed on the phone, like File Manager, App Manage, Facebook and WhatsApp. I have noticed that phone is facing problem to download apps and games from Google Play Store. And to solve this problem, just force stop App Manage app from settings menu and your problem will be solved. If you know any other workaround to solve this problem, do let me know in the comment section below. Qmobile Neuer S6 comes with 2500 mAh user replaceable battery. I usually prefer user replaceable battery, especially country like us where power fluctuation is a common issue and your battery is the component which get affected the most. If you are using expensive mobile phone or phone with non-removable battery, I recommend you to use good quality power bank for charging your phone. Battery timing on Qmobile Neuer S6 is average, even though it has low power CPU and only 720p display. I get around 4 hours of screen on time. I use the phone with highest brightness during my testing, so it is quite possible you might get better battery time, as battery time depends on how you use your phone. It takes around 2 hours to charge a device. Qmobile Neuer S6 comes with 13 megapixel back and 5 megapixel front camera. Camera interface is very old and such interface was used in Android Jelly Beans OS. Even though it is a selfie oriented phone, this phone has only 5 megapixel front camera, which is a bummer. Picture quality of front camera is average. If you are a person who heavily relies on selfie, then I suggest you to look other option. Let me show you shutter speed and image quality of the phone. So that was Qmobile Neuer S6 review. Gaming review will be coming soon on this channel. Please don't forget to subscribe to my channel. If you like this video, please hit the like button. If you have any questions, feedback or suggestions, do let me know in the comment section below. For more information, please do visit my website.